Monitors these days are getting thinner and thinner when it comes to the bezel and even general thickness. But this Asus ProArt PA32UCX-PK is actually one thick boy at 93mm thick and 69 times better than most monitors when it comes to professional color accurate work. But why though? If you're a colorist, video photo editor, illustrator, or any other sort of designer who cares about color, stay tuned to find out why size matters when it comes to monitors. Actually, not so much the size, but the thickness. That's what she said. So have you ever been in a situation where you color graded a video based on your monitor and it looks awesome, but when you upload it into the interwebs, okay, I know I'm old, it looks horrible on your smartphone, your girlfriend's laptop, even your father's plasma TV. Well, movies, TV shows, and Netflix videos are actually professionally color graded on color accurate monitors, which serve as a reference point when it comes to color. Now, every other manufacturer out there will use this reference point as the reference point when tuning their products. So if you use a color accurate monitor to color grade, you're gonna get a more pleasing result in general. So if you're someone like me who needs a color accurate monitor when it comes to creative professional work like video photo editing, 3D work, or even architectural stuff, then you'll definitely prefer an IPS monitor over a VA or TN panel. IPS monitors have come a long way. Believe me, I know, I'm old. We've not only seen an upgrade in maximum resolution, but also one important change that we are seeing when it comes to the technology actually has to do with the backlighting. Now, we started with edge lit, which slowly evolved into something called FALD, or full array local dimming. And now they've even taken it one step further with Mini LED. Now, Mini LED not only aims to increase maximum brightness and contrast ratio, but also combat a very serious IPS illness called the IPS glow. Without further ado, let's take a deeper dive into the world's first mini LED monitor, the Asus ProArt PA32UCX-PK. I will PK you tonight if you bring your monitor to my office. If I win, you leave your monitor and you go home a loser. The Asus PA32UCX-PK is priced at 7,888 ringgit and comes with an included Asus ProArt i1 Display Pro powered by X-Rite, which normally costs around $285 US or 1,500 ringgit. Firstly, let's take a look at the aesthetics. Now, this monitor looks very minimalist and sleek. It is mostly black with golden accents all over that screams premium. The front of the screen is mostly bezel-less except for a small strip at the bottom with a golden Asus logo embedded in the middle, and this makes it easy to have a seamless multiple monitor setup if you get more than one of these. Along the top and sides, you'll find vents that are used to expel heat, which I think probably comes from the Mini LED backlight. The chassis that houses the screen and the Mini LED backlight is mostly plastic on the outside with a brushed metal-like finish and another golden Asus logo embedded at the back. The back is also where you will find the OSD or on-screen display controls, including a control stick at the top followed by 6 buttons, with the bottom one being the on-off switch. At the bottom, you'll find the I/O ports that are concealed behind a removable cover. There's also a rubber monitor hood that has a satin-like finish on the inside to block out ambient light, and it installs via quite a few push-in pins, which honestly I find to be quite tedious. The stand, however, is made of metal and is quite interesting and unique, with a glass window that shows the monitor's height adjustment. It is cylindrical and tapers at the bottom to meet a large rectangular base, which also bears an Asus and ProArt logo, as well as a striking golden strip reminiscent of the red ring on an L-series Canon glass. Ergonomics-wise, the monitor has a wide swivel range of 60 degrees both ways. It tilts 5 degrees down and 23 degrees up, and has a pivot range of up to 90 degrees, which means that you can turn it into portrait mode. You also have up to 130mm of height adjustment, which in total would give you a lot of freedom in movement, even if you don't use a VESA mount compatible arm. Pay in mind that if you want to use an arm, you'll need something very strong because the monitor is quite hefty. In terms of dimensions, this monitor is 727mm wide, 426mm tall, and 93mm thick. The base itself is 350mm wide, 14mm thick, and 240mm deep. It also weighs 9.7 kilograms without the stand and 14.64 kilograms with the stand. This monitor has tiny speakers that are top firing, which is nothing to shout about. Get it? But I guess it's still handy to have. It's just that you're not gonna be doing your mixes on it, that's for sure. Moving on, let's take a closer look at the specifications of this monitor. The Asus ProArt PA32UCX-PK has a 32-inch 4K IPS panel with a true resolution of 3840 by 2160 pixels, display viewing area of 708.48 by 398.52 millimeters. It also has a non-glare display surface and a pixel pitch of 0.1845 millimeters. The contrast ratio here is 1000 to 1 typical and 1 million to 1 HDR stated by Asus. Also, since this is an IPS monitor, you're gonna get excellent viewing angles, which is especially important for a large monitor like this, and it means that you can actually move around when you work. Finally, we have a very common 5ms response time, a flicker-free, as well as the very important 1152-zone full array local dimming Mini LED backlight. But what makes Mini LED so special? What makes it any different from normal FALD backlighting? So Mini LED backlights has LEDs which are below 200 microns in size and that can be packed into more dimming zones for increased control over brightness. This also results in better brightness uniformity, contrast and sustained brightness. And speaking of brightness, they are capable of pushing this monitor to a max peak brightness of 1200 nits. This allows the monitor to display three different HDR modes, namely HLG, Dolby Vision and HDR10 accurately and conforms to Visa's Display HDR 1000 certification and goes beyond HDR10's peak brightness of 1000 nits. Few consumer monitors can compete with these specs except for the one from the famous Fruit brand that costs a lot more. For color, this monitor actually has a true 10-bit panel which is capable of showing up to 1.07 billion colors, which is 64 times, not 69 times, more than an ordinary 8-bit panel that is only capable of showing 16.7 million colors. How basic. In fact, some monitors that are advertised with a 10-bit panel actually use something called FRC, which attempts to get their very normal 8-bit panel to display 10-bit colors through something called dithering, but they're still far inferior when compared to a true 10-bit panel. Okay, just a refresher before we go to the test. Dynamic range refers to range of darkness to brightness that can be displayed by monitor or the content itself. SDR or standard dynamic range, which is used for conventional videos for a cinema, TV and such, typically covers around 6 stops of light. HDR or high dynamic range content goes up to 17.6 stops and requires a higher maximum brightness to display properly. And in this case, we have a 1200 nits display with the Asus ProArt monitor. With HDR, you will see more details in dark scenes before it clips to complete blackness and more details in highlights before it blows up and turns completely white. With SDR, you're gonna have to choose between displaying more details in your dark scenes or highlights. Now, for a monitor to be color accurate for HDR content, you don't just need a high maximum brightness, you also need a wide color gamut panel capable of covering more than the standard Rec. 709 color space, which is used for most videos these days. Basically, anything more than Rec. 709 is considered wide color gamut because they cover a wider spectrum of colors in relation to the CIE 1931 XY chromaticity diagram. In ascending order, sRGB that is used for mostly web and computer graphics cover about 33.5% of the diagram. Rec. 709 that is used for HDTV covers 35.8% of the diagram. Adobe RGB that is used for printed media covers 52.1%. DCI-P3 mainly for digital cinema covers 53.6%. And the new Rec. 2020 that is the new standard for 2012 UHD TVs covers about 75.8% of the diagram. Asus states that this monitor covers 89% Rec. 2020, 99.5% Adobe RGB, 99% DCI-P3, and 100% sRGB color spaces. In addition, for Adobe RGB and sRGB, there's a color difference value of a delta E less than 1, which means that it's accurate enough that your eyes can't tell the difference upon close inspection.
Our tests using the provided X-Rite i1 Display Pro seem to correlate those numbers, which are shown via the calibration certificate that was attached with the monitor as well. Furthermore, the monitor is generous with the I/O ports containing two Thunderbolt 3 USB-C, three HDMI 2.0B, one DisplayPort 1.2, and it also comes with three powered USB 3.0 ports for connecting external hard drives and other devices like mice and keyboards. Some of the special features that come with this Asus ProArt monitor is firstly the Asus ProArt calibration technology that allows you to store calibration settings into the monitor and let you carry it across different devices. And there's also picture-in-picture and picture-by-picture mode that allow you to preview your content in two different HDR modes side by side, and is especially useful for those who color grade for multiple delivery standards. We also get HDR preview, which allows for a full tonal range preview with a captured HDR content straight from your camera, and I find it very useful when you're trying to capture anything that you want to grade in HDR but you don't have a separate HDR monitor like an Atomos Shogun. Of course, this is huge and you can't take it out of the studio. HDR preview also automatically works in video editing software, enabling creators to view accurate simulations of the final output for an easier and more streamlined editing process. With a PC like me, you're gonna need something like this Blackmagic Decklink Mini Monitor 4K for around 1000 ringgit or $195 in order to view HDR content properly. So basically, a dedicated video playback and capture device like this sends out HDR metadata, whether it be PQ or HLG, to your monitor or TV. Your GPU is not capable of doing this, so if you don't have one, you'll be doing this blindly. Then you'll need to set up your color grading software like DaVinci Resolve right here with the proper settings to grade HDR. There are shockingly few tutorials online for this, so please leave a comment down below if you want to see more HDR tutorials from me in the future. We're gonna go with the Rec 2020 Color Space and Rec 2100 HLG Gamma for the demonstration today, so leave a comment down below if you want us to go more in detail into the different color spaces and gamma. So as you can see in the scope section, under waveform, there's a chart that goes from 0 to 1000 nits. Now SDR content was conventionally designed to go up to 0 to 100 nits, but HDR content goes way beyond than that. In fact, HDR 10 goes up to 1000 nits, and HDR 10 Plus, which already exists today, goes up to 4000 nits. For reference, this image from LumaForge shows us different brightness values in the real world measured with a photometer. You'll notice that some areas already far exceed the 10,000 nits soft cap from HDR. Now this image was graded in SDR and the Rec 709 color space, and what Colorist to this point has been doing is cram in huge range of data in the highlight, mid-tone, and as well as the shadows in this tiny of a space between 0 to 100 nits. What happens is that the highlights and shadows get selectively crushed to give us a more natural look with more contrast, kind of like this. So in comparison, in HDR as well as the Rec 2020 color space and HLG gamma, you're gonna get firstly a lot more color information as shown in this CIE chromaticity diagram. Secondly, we're gonna be able to move beyond that 100 nits limit, as you can see right here. And what it does is allows us to put a lot of that detail in these brighter areas closer to the 1000 nits mark. And this allows us to distinguish more details in the highlights as well as the shadows. And overall, this gives us a lot more latitude of grading for higher contrast, more details, and more saturated colors. Now, since we're delivering this video in SDR, you won't be able to see a lot of the details here, but we are going to be uploading a HDR version to YouTube so you can actually see the difference for yourself. Links in the YouTube description box below.
So what do we think about the Asus ProArt PA32UCX-PK? Well, firstly, let's take a look at the pros first. First and foremost, 1200 nits of brightness is crazy, and it has also a very consistent brightness throughout as well, which is good. Secondly, you have very uniform colors, which is quite crazy for a monitor this size. Most monitors above 27 inches in our experience tend to have uniformity issues, but this one is not really a problem here. Number three, you can store calibration settings onto the monitor itself, which is very handy to have if you want to move your monitor around. I don't see why you would, because it is huge, but it is there if you need it. Number four, you have multiple HDR modes, which makes it very flexible when grading based on different standards. Number five, you have generous amounts of I/O. So no matter what you want to plug into it, no problem. You can plug your laptop, your PC, and even your mother no teach Apple product. Number six, you have wide viewing angles, which is really good to have with a color accurate monitor for color accurate work, especially because this is huge. Number seven, it is an insane amount of value at 7,888 ringgit. You might not think that, but if you Google color accurate monitors, you will see a lot more professional options out there, which is a lot more expensive, that can go up to 20 grand, 30 grand and up. Also, you can actually grade RED or Arri Alexa footage on this thing. That is just insane for 7,888 ringgit. Hashtag cheap buy. Oh yeah, before I forgot, number eight, it also comes with a free Asus ProArt i1 Display Pro powered by X-Rite, which would normally cost around $285 for free. Moving on to the man. And honestly, I'm just nitpicking here, but I wish that the monitor could be a little bit sturdier. As you can see, it wobbles quite a bit when we use the OSD and stuff like that. But again, I'm just nitpicking. I'm probably gonna be using this monitor with a very hefty arm anyways, because I want a little bit more flexibility, as well as saving some desk space to put more of my things. I'm a bangsawan, I have a lot of things. And for the cons, and this is solely out of completeness, I don't like the hood because it's rather flimsy and the installation method is quite tedious as well. You need to put in quite a few tacks to put it in properly. And also, there's no cutout on the top hood when it comes to putting in the calibrator. I mean, they give this free. They should at least cut a hole here, ma. So when I want to use it, I can just slot through without removing the hood. How much fun, you know? So what's the verdict? Well, I give this monitor a very solid Philip Bloom also be proud. 9 out of 10 and 9! Asus, you can't take this back. Just send me an invoice. I'm gonna buy this and keep this and use this like my new baby. If you thought this video is awesome, don't forget to give this a like and share. Leave a comment down below to let us know what other kind of color accurate workflows you guys do. And also, would you be interested in a thick boy like this? If you would, we will be friends. Imagine that. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell to see more content like this, and follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more shenanigans from the Mob House crew. And I will see you in the next one. See, today I give you extra hand movement because you say that I have more hand movement than Italians. Well, Chinese people also like to do this. Malaysian people also like to do this. So we are one big family. Just like this 32-inch monitor, very big, very family friendly.